Hello, I'm Hayden Winwitzie here with Cameron Wood, and today we'll be covering high school sports and European soccer. I'll start off by talking about Christian Brothers' 2-point win over Briarcrest on Friday night with a buzzer beater coming from Andre Wilson. And the JV started off the night with a 10-point victory, 55-45. Also Friday night, MUS defeated SBA 47-35. East defeated White Station 116-86 with Nick Smith, Dylan Mitchell, and their head coach being ejected. And also Hamilton won a thriller 61-58 over Whitehaven. And then Monday night, Hamilton defeated White Station by 20, but I was never able to get a final score. And Tuesday night, the brothers will take on Center Hill at home, hoping to defend that 22-0 record.
In Spain, first place Real Madrid was challenged over the weekend by Cordoba, but a late penalty by Gareth Bale made the final 2-1. Second place Barcelona had no trouble keeping up as they defeated Elche 6-0. The scoring was started by defender Piqué, and strikers Neymar and Messi both picked up 2 goals. French powerhouse PSG maintained their third place spot by defeating Saint-Étienne over the weekend. The lone goal of the game came from a Zlatan Ibrahimovic penalty. Olympique Lyon, the leaders, maintained their 4-point lead by defeating Metz 2-0. The goals were in Italy. There was some good games over the weekend, with Juventus defeating Chievo 2-0. The goals were from Pogba and Lichtensteiner, while second place Roma only got 1 point by drawing Fiorentina 1-1. The English Premier League took the week off to entertain the FA Cup, which is the oldest trophy in European soccer. Top-tier sides Chelsea and Manchester City both lost to lower-level teams Bradford City and Middlesbrough, respectively.
Now we're going to turn it over to Austin and David Midlick for professional sports coverage.
Hi, I'm David Millick. I'm here with Austin Lee, and we're doing some professional sports coverage. Starting with your local town Grizzlies, on Saturday the 24th, the Grizzlies handled the 76ers 101-83 behind Jeff Green's 18 points. And yesterday on Monday the 26th, the Grizzlies beat Orlando Magic 103-94. Zach Randolph had a double-double with 24 points and 10 rebounds. The Grizzlies are 32-12 this season and second in the Western Conference behind Golden State. An update on Mike Conley, he's still nursing a sprained wrist injury. Notable games from Monday, the Thunder defeated the Timberwolves 92-84. The Pelicans defeated the 76ers 99-74. The Clippers defeated the Nuggets 102-98. The Celtics defeated the Jazz 99-90. The Blazers, Nets, and Knicks-Kings games were both postponed due to the snow and blizzard up in the Northeast. And updates from the league, LeBron and the Cavaliers are on a 6-game win streak, and Kobe underwent surgery for his torn rotator cuff. I'll send it over to Austin.
This week in football, there was a slight break because it's only one game left, and that's the Super Bowl between the Seattle Seahawks and the New England Patriots. And there's a lot of discussion going around because of Deflategate. Did they deflate the balls? Did they not? Who knows? But in the bye week, there was a Senior Bowl and Pro Bowl, which the MVP of the Senior Bowl was Amir Abdullah, the running back from Nebraska. He had an outstanding game. And Team Irvin took the victory over Team Carter. And now we send it over to Sam for college sports.
Thank you, Austin. And for some college basketball news, Coach K got his 1,000th victory this past Sunday, defeating St. John's 77-68. What an accomplishment. And other local news, Arkansas improved to 15-4, edging Missouri 61-60. Tennessee lost to Texas A&M, dropping to 12-6, 67-61. Ole Miss improved to 12-7, beating Florida in a tight one, 72-71. And your Memphis Tigers improved to 12-7 with a last-second buzzer beater by Austin Nichols to beat Tulane 57-55. In the rankings news, Kentucky remained undefeated at 19-0, beating South Carolina. Virginia remained at 19-0 as well, beating Virginia Tech. And to round out the top five are Gonzaga, Duke, and Wisconsin. And that is your local college basketball news.